An MP, a life peer, but was Lord Janner a child abuser too? He always denied the claims, but now we know police were reluctant to investigate, and when they did, they shut down their operations without pursuing all the inquiries. This independent report says his accusers were grossly let down by multiple failings.
The children that were involved were in care at the time, which brings with it its own challenges. They've been listened to as part of the inquiry. Historically, they weren't, and hopefully this report gives them some closure and makes them feel like they've been listened to and that lessons have been learned and that the inquiry has been worthwhile, really.
This inquiry received information relating to 33 alleged victims spanning three decades. They were let down by institutional failings, the report finds. In Operation Magnolia, led by Leicestershire Police in 2000, there was a deliberate decision to withhold key witness statements from the Crown Prosecution Service. And in the Force's Operation Dauntless, complaints were again not fully investigated. Leicestershire County Council was also found to have a sorry record of failures in relation to the abuse of children in its care at the time, and that further inquiries should have been made by them about Lord Janner. All of those institutions today acknowledge their past mistakes, but what now? The report makes no recommendations, as it was felt significant change has already occurred.
How can we be confident that these organisations have changed? Because we're only looking at the last sort of 20 years. It's fairly recent still, isn't it?
It is. I mean, we do see evidence that things have changed, but in many cases things are changing slowly. We're seeing cultural changes happening, but obviously we'd all like to see that sped up. We'd all like to see all organisations doing this thing at pace.
Following a further police investigation, Lord Janner was due to stand trial. But he died in 2015, shortly before it started. His family today said this new report fails to challenge his innocence and offers no proof of his guilt. Julian Drucker, 5 News.